this dream one night. I was riding this board. It was about 8 feet long, stubby, climbing and dropping on a big 8 to 10 foot wave, and crank the vertical face instead of running across the wave. I'm going to make a surfboard that can do that.
This little machine, if the walking's cut out, see, I'm going to walk to the back of the board to manoeuvre it, and you stay right where you are and just go whammy.
It had this fascinating turn with this deep V bottom. You could roll into these turns and do these big arcs.
I got A's in calculus. My ambition was to design the modern surfboard. I wouldn't let anybody touch my board.
Dope was an influence on everything throughout that surfing movement, from board design to music.
I first met McTavish with him and some other bloke came illegally on a boat.
The Hawaiian surfers, their boards were so big, these guys were doing one big slow turn and going straight. How disappointing.
I grabbed a saw. I cut a foot off.
When I get up there and get that power, you just go, phew.
One of the most influential surfboards ever made was the Big Pipeliner by Dick Brewer.
This is before McTavish showed up. My part of history was already in a design standpoint.
And then the board went vertically right back up the face.
McTavish was shredding the hell out of it.
That board went like the clappers.
The media perceived that the Aussies invented this whole thing, and they didn't. It was basically a Brewer Hawaii thing.
The shortboard revolution definitely started in Australia months before it happened in Hawaii.
Our thinking was so far advanced from where they were.
He didn't see what was happening here.
I thought he was an idiot.
I don't give a damn.
Something's going on, man. That was the future, surfing.
Going vertical, the real story of the shortboard revolution.